guys, welcome back to the channel. It's a beautiful day. We're on the monkey. I think today we're going to ride to Burkittsville, where they filmed the Blair Witch Project. Nice little sleepy town. About 15 miles away. So, let's go. Are you gonna go or? Sorry about the lawnmower noise. I'm not 100% sure how to get there from here, but you know what? That's part of the adventure, right? So I've had the monkey now for probably about a month. And if you watch my previous videos, I am a first-time rider. I mean, I have the ruckus, but first time motorcycle rider, and I learned how to ride this thing in a day. That's how easy it is. It's the perfect beginner motorcycle. It's the perfect, I want to go have fun. I'm not worried about going super fast, which I'm not. I never want to take this thing on a motorcycle go on a highway. So this is the perfect bike if you just want to have fun, relax. Not one time have I felt like I've not had control of this thing or felt uncomfortable. And I really like this about that bike. So where we're going is Burkittsville. It's where they shot, like I said, they shot the Blair Witch Project. It's most famous for it's the cemetery in Burkittsville, where they shot a couple of the scenes, and they shot a couple of scenes downtown, but the rest of it was like in the woods somewhere, and I have no clue where that's at. But we'll ride down to the cemetery. It is definitely cool out this morning. It's 52 degrees. It definitely feels like fall in the air here in Maryland. So like I said, I've had the monkey for about a month now, and it's just a really fun bike. Easy to control, easy to drive, easy to learn. I mean, I'm still going through some growing pains with the thing, you know, being a first time rider, you know, downshifting sometimes and a little not as smooth, but I mean, that all comes in time. So if you're thinking about, you know, hey, look, I want to get a motorcycle, but you know, I don't want to feel, I want to just go back road, go through the back roads, go through town, have a little commuter bike. This is perfect. This or the Grom. I don't have a Grom, but I'm definitely planning on getting a Grom. Probably around March of next year. So I'll have the Ruckus, the Monkey, and the Grom. I do love the Honda bikes. So I probably have about 2 months of riding. September, October, November starts to get pretty cold. I mean, you can have some nice days, but your consistent rides, you got to take advantage of the next 2 months. Stop here a second. I don't think my strap is on. Nope. So we're going to take as many back roads as we can to Burkittsville. We have to get on some 50 mile an hour roads, but which is good. I'll show you how this thing runs. Opens up a little bit. We're just going to take our time. Some debris in the road. We just had Ida come through, give us lots of floods, lots of wind, but it cooled it off. It got the humidity out of here. It won't be long. I have to put the liner back in this jacket. So I've had the Monkey out on 50 mile an hour roads, and it's definitely, I've gotten it up to almost 60, and it keeps up with traffic. You're not in people's way. Gets a lot of thumbs ups. People like the style of it. I've only been riding a motorcycle for a month, so I'm not 100% comfortable, but I'm like 95% on this because I don't feel like I'm out of control at all. And people buy these things and they want them to go faster. Well, if you want to go faster, don't buy a Monkey. Don't buy this kind of motorcycle. That's what I think about it. To me, this is like an heirloom. This is something I want to keep for years and years and years and just keep it pristine. I'm not going to run through mud puddles or drive in the mountains with it. Dirt roads. Well, I might take it on a dirt road. It's not too bad. Tell you what, it's chilly. I should have put the liner in this jacket. Great scenery out here. this is the Sharpsburg area here. We're passing the prison area. If any of my viewers are from Maryland, Hagerstown. We're on the outskirts of Hagerstown. Still consider Hagerstown, but it's not downtown. It's more towards Sharpsburg, where the battlefield was. Was, is. I do believe I have to make a turn up here somewhere. Experienced rider told me, even as a beginner, don't ride scared, because you know, if you ride panic, you're scared, you know. That's why people get, you have to get a bike that's right for you and comfortable in the beginning. There's no way I'd go out and get a 600, 700, 800, you know, cc bike, because I don't feel like I'm that experienced, and I don't want to go fast. I just want to cruise, you know? Well, eventually, I like the Honda Rebel 300. Will I get that? Maybe. Maybe. It's not that big of a bike. Yeah, the Rebel 300 is pretty cool. A lot of one-lane bridges here. That water's gone down a lot. Only thing I wish the monkey did have was the gear indicator, like the Grom has, to let you know when to shift and stuff. I mean, I pretty much have gotten it down, but sometimes you forget what gear you're in. This road is going to take us out to alternate 40 towards Boonesboro, and once we go through Boonesboro, got like a 6 mile stretch. Shit, I only got one bar. We have to stop and get some gas. Roxbury Hill. They started cutting the corn down. Cruising around in third gear. Another thing I like about the mini motos is they're so affordable. So I got the Ruckus, and that was like $2,700. But you know, it's a little more because you got tags and all that crap. But I paid that off in a year. I plan on paying this off by March, and just getting the Grom in the spring. So, you know, you're not like buying a $20,000-$30,000 bike. This was $3,800. So, very affordable. Now, this is really a one-lane bridge here. All right. Now, we're going to make a right up here. I hope we pass a gas station, because I don't want to be the one to run out of gas. Now we open her up a little bit. I think it's like 50 through here. Yeah, it's 50. A lot of open country, you know, all these, good way to get experience. School bus is back out. Sorry for the loud wind noise. I'm gonna drop it down to 40. I want to stay in the speed limit. I cannot believe how chilly it is. Alright, there's a Dollar General. We need a gas station. Probably cost a whole $3 to fill this thing up. And it goes about 180 miles. Between 180 and 160. Well, there's an AC&T. Stop and get some gas. Well, maybe we're not going to AC&T. I thought I could get here from here, but I guess we can get some gas here that's wise. Got our gas. Let's get back on the road. This thing going neutral. Hope this thing has enough weight to trigger that light. I've noticed that sometimes when I'm at a light, it'll skip because the bike isn't heavy enough, so. Definitely happens on the Ruckus all the time. Come on, buddy, are you turning or are you just riding with your blinker on? Now we're in the town of Boonesboro, Maryland. Nice little quiet town. Come down here in the summer, they got nice little farmers markets and get some fresh fruit, vegetables. Thank you. Another thing about the Monkey is the seat. I tell you what, like, it, no matter how long you ride, the seat is just like sitting on a nice soft pillow the whole time. Incredibly good job that Honda did on the seat on this thing. Now we got some open road here. We're on this stretch of road for about 5 or 6 miles. Speed limit's 55. Fifty-one, fifty-two, fifty-three, fifty-six, fifty-seven, fifty-eight, fifty-nine, sixty. Hit 60 on this thing. That's the first time I hit 60. I think I hit like 57, 58, but I don't think I've ever hit 60. And you know, this is pretty good for, this motor's not even broke in yet. I only have 196 miles on this thing. The break-in mileage on this thing is 600. And as soon as I get 600, I'll show you how to do an oil change on this. Very simple. Just really one thing you have to do. Man, you couldn't ask for a better day to ride today. But this is definitely good for the Monkey, breaking it in fourth gear, opening up, get that motor nice and hot. Moonshine, where the hell we got the moonshine at? Look at this crazy nut. This is 55 speed limit, probably going about 75. Two vehicles behind me, so he passed a lot of vehicles. He must be late for work. Lost a little speed going up that hill. I got her wide open. 55. We're going to speed limit, that's the main thing. We've got a tanker truck behind us, but he's a good distance back. So in some places, in some states, 55 is the speed limit. So, I mean, theoretically, if you were on a road like this, I mean, I wouldn't take it on an interstate. I mean, this thing would do fine. And I'm pulling away from the tanker now. It does lose a little bit up the hills though. I mean, this is a slight hill and we're going 51. Just hit 200 miles. Now the tanker truck's pulling off. There's nobody behind us. So we're good. Just got to remember what road we need to take to get to Burkittsville. Another month or so, the scenery will be awesome with the leaves. With all this rain here in September, the leaves should be full of color here in another month and a half. No, not even not a month and a half. What am I talking about? It is September. About another 3 or 4 weeks. I tried to Google map the complete back way to this place. Couldn't find it. Now we're almost up to 60 again. We're going downhill. Gatlin is the road we need. And I think the Gatlin Road is up here. It's up here. Because I know there's a state park up here we have to pass as well. Kind of slow down here a little bit, take all this in. Like I say, there's some great scenery up here. That was pretty cool. That was a nice wide open stretch of flat, kind of flat road to open this thing up. And I say we got it up to 60. I couldn't hit 61, but that's good. So I'm filming with the Casio V50 Pro. And the V50 Pro does have a mic, so I do have a mic, so inside the helmet. Yeah, like I say, another month or so, this is gonna be beautiful. I mean, it's beautiful now, but it's gonna be full of color. Play some camping back there. If you've never been to Burkittsville, you're gonna be amazed, because it's like the town that time forgot. I mean, it's crazy how old it looks. Now this is a cool structure here. That was cool. There's also a legend there's a tunnel down here. I think I've been there as a teenager. Ooh, it's a little old cemetery. But if you put your car in neutral, the soldiers will push it up. Some kind of illusion. I don't think it's real. But something cool, you know, something cool you could do if you're ever in this area. Here we are, Burkittsville. That's not the original sign. After the movie was made, there's so many fans coming to this town of the movie that they actually stole the original Burkittsville sign that was in the movie, and they replaced them with those. There's another one down here. But we'll stop at the cemetery. We'll go through the town. Respect the speed limit of 20. See, it just looks just a quiet little town. One road, one main road anyway. And one stop sign. Cemetery's up here. Alright, we are going into the cemetery where they filmed the Blair Witch Project. And we're getting a little off-roading on the monkey here. Oh, what a view. Alright, we'll stop. Check out some of the graves. I'll film some stuff on my phone. Oh, it's awesome. Nice and cool and breezy. And like I said, I'll get some shots with my phone and see if we can match up some of the grave sites and stuff like that.
All right, so this would have been the shot. This would have been the shot where she was doing the interview. You had the, I don't think it said Fluke on the grave at that time, but you had the little grave there, and then you had the three little ones right there you can see in the shot. And I'll have the picture up here in the corner so you can compare. So this is where she was doing the interview overlooking the valley. Just a beautiful countryside. There's a sunflower seed field. Yeah, there's still a few graves we need to find. The one that says infant and the angel. It'll be around here somewhere. So we're just gonna keep on walking around. We'll find them right back.
Okay, this is one of the graves that were used in the movie.
Anna May. A small little grave there. That's one of them. And I'll have a picture on the side to kind of do a little comparison. Yeah, there's a lot of very unique tombstones in the cemetery, but this cemetery is very old. It's really quiet and eerie. I believe this shot was in the movie too. Go ahead and take a look at that. Just a lot of old. And this one tucked underneath this tree here.
All right, so I got some shots on my phone of the town. And this is the cemetery, and this is the view. So we're gonna get back on the monkey. We're gonna drive through town, see if we can find that tunnel, and then that will be the end of this adventure. Eyeball helmet today.
I did find some of the graves from the movie. There's one I couldn't find. It's the one that says infant, but I might have to come back around Halloween and see if I can't find it. I have some more time. So that is the Burkittsville Cemetery where they filmed the Blair Witch Project. Let's go. Let's make a left. Ooh, rev it up. Oh, that's a cool old building. I don't know if you could see that on the camera or not. Their street signs are like old wooden signs. That's pretty cool. Mr. UPS man. I think this is like the edge of town, like right here. This is it. So we'll turn around down here. I think the tunnel is back the other way. Turn around here. Just mountains surrounding this whole place. It's been a nice, really nice place to live. This must be the turnaround here. We might even, we passed that state park. There's some really cool scenery there, so we might stop there too. So I don't know, I'm 5'10", about 160, and you see how I fit on the bike. There's plenty of room. Excuse me. Yeah, when this, very comfortable bike. Love the monkey. No buyer's remorse here. Okay, I thought that tunnel was off to the left, but maybe not. Burkittsville Vineyard. Some bamboo. There was a little cemetery up here, but I didn't see anywhere where you could pull off and go in there. It was right down in there. That old church, man, that would be cool. Nowhere to park. That is a really cool structure. Let's see. Make a left up here. I'd like to get over to that other side. I don't see a darn driveway to get in there. Oh, I see the parking lot. There's some pretty cool things around here. What the hell is going on? So I think we'll end our adventure here. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe. Till the next time, to the next adventure, we are out of here.